everyone, how are you all doing? My name is Deborah and I am here to give you my second impression. I am here to give you my second impression of the 8, and I know it's been a while since I made my first impression, but I literally just finished watching episode 24. Was it yesterday or the day before yesterday? I can't even remember right now. All my days are mixed when I walk, like literally every day of the week. But anyways, I did watch it and I'm like, oh my gosh, this is the perfect ending to come and give my second impression. So I didn't watch because I know now 30 episodes are out, but I'm like, let me just come and give my second impression. So my third impression will be the next 12 episodes till 30. It's gonna be 12 episodes, right? 24 plus 6 7 8 9 10. Oh no, 6 more episodes before it gets to 13. Or maybe it will be the next 12 episodes. We shall see. But anyways, I'm like, let me just watch this first and then I'll come and give you guys my review. So here we are. If you've not watched my first impression, just know that this is gonna have spoilers, because I'm assuming if you're watching this, you've already watched the 8 up to where I am. Otherwise, just stop watching. If you don't mind spoilers, you can keep watching. But grab your tea mugs and come along with me as we discuss the 8. Let's go. Alright, so my second impression of the 8, I'm gonna do it differently. I'm gonna kind of go along with the way the drama is doing it in terms of like tackling each sect. Like once they're done with the entertainers, then they move to the thousand hands, then they move to the poisoners and all that and all that. So that's how I'm gonna tackle it. So let me start with the person that I want to talk about first. Just get this out of the way that will basically lead to the other group. So the first group that I want to tackle are the spies. So was I the only one that was literally done with his sister? This 12 episodes leading to 24, like I thought she was smart. I always thought his sister was smart. Don't get me wrong, she didn't annoy me in terms of like, oh, their romance or anything like that. Not in that way. But I always thought the sister was smart. And I assumed she had to also be smart considering she's like the head of the spies, right? But what shocked me at how not smart she is was when she just chose to believe in his dad, like Guarin Chu's dad, just like that, just because he told her a few words and she just bought into his words and just believed him. Like, girlfriend, even if you had like heard him and stuff, you could have pretended that you believed him and then put him through a couple of tests before you just buy into the, oh my goodness, I'm trying to protect my son image and all that he's trying to portray in front of you. Like, how dumb can you be? So that really annoyed me with her character this week, how she just fell for his tricks really, really fast. But I must admit, I was pretty shocked with the revelation of who her assistant really is and the fact that he works for Guarin Chu's dad. That was the only thing I never saw coming throughout these 24 episodes that I have watched. I never saw that coming. So that was really shocking. And so, oh, I also didn't see coming that she was a spy, the leader of the spy. But I mean, in terms of like something that actually really did shock me, it was the fact that her assistant actually works for Guarin Chu's dad that shocked me. That was a really good plot twist. So I really like that plot twist. But I'm happy that we didn't have to wait till episode 30 or something for her to find out that Guarin Chu's dad is bad. So I'm glad that we've gotten that out of the way already, that she knows now whatever decision she makes after that, if she still chooses to walk along with him, that's where we can all throw our stones at her and stuff. I haven't reached the stone throwing stage yet. I'm just kind of disappointed in her because I expected her to be smarter than that. But I'm glad that she found out the truth and in the process also found out that her right hand man is also one of the bad guys. So that was really, really good. So I liked that. Now, all that aside, let's move to the next group. And the next group I'm gonna address are the Thousand Hands. The Thousand Hands, I was so annoyed that they didn't figure out, like Guarin Chu didn't figure out that it wasn't the Queen of the Entertainers and stuff and Zimin that were basically betraying the Thousand Hands and that it was someone else. it really, really frustrated me that he didn't find that out and he didn't chase after it, because you think he chased after it, because even though you leave and you save the girl you're trying to save from being harmed, that doesn't mean, oh, the spy in the midst of them is just gonna die, or that's the end of the spy, as we come to see at the end of 24 and stuff. The spy is still gonna serve a purpose in the future, so you should at least try to root out that problem. But he never tried to root it out, so that was something that I just really found weird with Kwan In-chul's character in that part. And I'm like, wait, he's really not trying to find out who the spy is, and we're just gonna move on just like that? And I thought, at first I actually thought he still suspected the queen of entertainers, until we find out later on that, oh, he doesn't suspect them anymore, and then he met with them again in, was it Beijing or Guangzhou? And I'm like, hold on, brah, like, you didn't even solve the spy problem, are we just gonna leave it like that? But I guess they were trying to leave it like that because they needed room for the second part of the drama, when everything hits the roof like it did in episode 34. But anyways, that's just something else with that scene that really bugged me. But apart from that, out of all the deaths we've had in this drama so far, the death that really touched me was the death of the leader of the Thousand Heads. Like, I really felt her death. Her death was really, really sad. Like, we grew to love her and we grew to care about her and how she cared for her children and stuff, like the people that are under her and stuff, the sect members. So we grew to love her and stuff. But her dying was just so sad. But it was a death that made sense to me, that I could make sense of. Unlike the next group that I'm gonna talk about, which is the mechanics. Now let's get to Keshu. I am convinced, I thought Yifang was my favorite, but I'm convinced I'm in love with Keshu, okay? Keshu is the cutest, sweetest, loveliest person ever. I'm convinced I'm in love with Keshu. But my issue with the mechanics line and the plot line of the mechanics was Keshu's father. Like, I knew right from the beginning, when we met Keshu's father, there were either two things that were gonna happen. Either one, Keshu's father was gonna die and then they will respect him after his death, or Keshu's father's ceramics was gonna save the mechanics. But then what really frustrated me with his death, that his death did not have the effect on me that it should have had, was the fact that his father clearly knew that he couldn't survive the gun attack. What he had created was not strong enough to survive this gun attack. And yet, he went to go imprison his son to take his son's place. For what? Does he... Hold up. Guys, I know. He's doing it because he cares for his son. Of course, he doesn't want to watch his son die, but please hear me out. Yes, he doesn't want his son to die. Yes, he's a father. But even a father should have the sense to know when your son has the ability to be able to save himself and save others. Like, it's known amongst everyone in that town that his son is literally the best of the best. Why can't you just trust your son to be able to create something that would have beat this guy down and stuff? And even I am like, if they had just let Keshu do that, Keshu would definitely have been able to create something that would be able to protect him against that gun. His life wouldn't have been lost. Now the father goes in, takes Keshu's place, the father ends up dying. What did the father expect exactly? That, oh, if he dies, the bad guy won't go against the Mo tribe or what? Like, what exactly were you expecting? Because your deaths basically didn't serve any purpose in terms of the bad guy still continued wanting to kill them until your son got angry because of your death and still ended up saving everyone. So if you had just not died, your son would have still saved everyone without you needing to die. So his death just felt useless to me, and I really didn't care about his death, and I wasn't crying. And I'm just like, this is really annoying right now. Like, this is actually annoying, guys. Like, very annoying. Like, what is the use of this death? This is the most useless death that just makes no sense. Like, it throws all reasoning out the window. But maybe that was the point, to show us the extent of a parent's love, that sometimes they just lose reasoning or something, I don't know. But but that death really, really bugged me and stuff, because I'm like, okay, I expected better. Seriously, this does not make sense to me, but maybe it makes sense to someone else and stuff, and the love of a parent conquers everything. But I feel like my parents will have the sense to trust me and know my ability. abilities and know whether I can literally do this thing that I'm saying I can do, right? Don't you think so? But anyways, that's just me. So that's how I feel about that. Next, let's talk about our main leads and our female leads and stuff. And oh, let's talk about the entertainers, then we'll go to our main lead and the female lead. So I wasn't shocked that the right hand lady of the queen of entertainers was actually someone bad. It was surprising, but it wasn't too shocking, like I said, like the other people and stuff. But that was also a scene that kind of like threw reasoning out the window. I feel like as we're moving forward in the episode, they're beginning to throw senses and sensibility out the window, because Zimin was told by the queen of entertainers' right-hand lady that, hey, you should go meet Huaminchu. Huaminchu's life is in danger. Shouldn't common sense have told him there's something weird here? Like, why should she just come and tell only me to go save Huaminchu? Why doesn't she also tell the queen of entertainers, why should I go save him when I'm not even really a part of the eight? Like, the main people that are in the eight, one of the main leaders of the eight is sitting right there. She didn't tell her to go save Huaminchu. She's coming to tell me to go save Huaminchu. Do you see where I'm coming from? Is it just me that this just does not make sense to stuff? No, man, seriously, this is very stupid to me. Like, you guys could have found a better reason and a better way to have written about this betrayal and how they fell for the trick, but this just doesn't make sense to me. Stuff, especially considering our people, and they trying to tell us that, oh, they were so in love that they couldn't see the light or something, and then they just made the queen of entertainers seem so weak in that scene. And I'm like, no, this is just not adding up. Like, there's so many things wrong in this situation that just don't make sense when you think about it and stuff. But anyways, that's just how I felt about that. Now on to our main leads. Our main leads, I absolutely love how their relationship has grown. I absolutely adore how they're really, really, really blossoming in front of us and stuff, and how it's literally been gradually growing, and you're beginning to see more of their chemistry and they're beginning to be bold with each other. I know that our female lead kind of slightly annoyed me. Like, she impressed me when she tried to trick Baijin and stuff, Mrs. Bai, about Huaminchu and stuff. She did impress me in that instant, but it was kind of disappointing how she was easily caught by Mrs. Bai and stuff. It was the same situation with the Thousand Hands girl, who basically went to Mrs. Bai's place to try to steal the scroll and stuff, and instead got injured. For her, I understand, because she's always been shown as someone that's impulsive. But for our female lead, I mean, that scene was just like, I understand, but I was kind of disappointed too in stuff, how she was easily caught and she needed to be saved. But I'm glad that it was Keshu that saved her. And is it just me, or can you guys see that Keshu is in love with her? Which is gonna be really, really sad, because you can just see his heart breaking, because she doesn't love him in that way. She loves her senior brother and stuff. But I really like how their relationship has grown. I wasn't surprised that he chose his sister when he was asked to choose between his sister and our female lead, who it is that he wanted to save. I wasn't shocked he chose his senior sister, because his senior sister's family literally gave him life. So it only made sense that he'd save his senior sister and then try to die along with our female lead, which is basically what he tried to do. Try to kill Fang Yuan Ji along with himself, blow them both up and stuff. So that wasn't shocking. But dang, that ended in episode 24, where we realized what was going on, that there's this whole new team of like the eight that is being created by Huaminchu's dad and stuff, and they're all like basically representing the different groups. The assassins were represented, the entertainers were represented, the thieves were represented, the boys, like, they were all represented. That was really shocking. I didn't see that coming. That was a really, really dope twist, how there's the good side and then there's the bad side, and now y'all are gonna fight against each other. So that was a really, really, really nice twist. I'm excited to see what's gonna happen going forward in that regard with the two teams, and just see the two groups fight each other and see who's more powerful than who and stuff. I know that our female lead is not gonna die and stuff. I know she's gonna survive. So I'm just wondering how she's gonna survive, because girlfriend literally put something through her that came out the other way that definitely pierced organs and stuff. So however she's gonna survive is gonna be a miracle, but I know she's gonna survive. So I'm looking forward to that. I'm very sure that that's gonna be the turning point in our relationship between our male and the female lead, where after that he's definitely not giving up her life for anything and stuff. It's gonna be them do or die, and their love is probably gonna be more pronounced. So I'm definitely looking forward to that. But yeah, let me know your thoughts in the comments down below. Have you checked out the recent episodes? If you have, let me know in the comments down below. I haven't yet watched the last 5 episodes of Love Designer for folks that are waiting for my final review. I'm gonna watch it sometime this week and then do my review this weekend. So watch out for that. Till next time, keep being awesome, beautiful people. You are from me to you all. You know, I'm just not in my love for you all. Stay awesome.